Well, here's the 3813. Got some updates. Put a set of gauges down there. As you can see, got coolant temperature, oil pressure, and battery. Still working out some bugs with the oil pressure temperature gauge. It's kind of sticking. Tractor runs at 160 once it warms up. I just started it, so. But I ran everything through here. Still got to do some cleaning up right there. Cover that up with something. Came through here. Battery voltage. This is all lit up too, so when you turn the key off. As you can see, the lights turn off and I can turn this on. The lights come back on, so is the battery voltage gauge. That's a mechanical oil pressure and coolant temperature gauge, so they will operate whether the ignition is on or not. But I use this corrugated shit, or whatever you call it. So the oil line that has to run up from the engine up to the dash doesn't rub on anything and puncture, and also just keep it clean. But it comes down under here, and then it tees off right here, and that goes, there's a fitting under your, or above your starter, and that goes to an oil passage right there. You take that out, and then you find a fitting that'll fit it, you screw it in there, and it's a compression fitting, and it goes on that little plastic hose, and then it runs oil all the way up to the gauge. And that's how that works with a mechanical gauge. And then as far as the temperature gauge goes, I went down here by the where the warning sending unit would be for your overheat. It's not really, I don't think it's a variable gauge. I think it's more of an on and off dummy switch. But so I got a new sending unit in there, and then like I said, it's not warmed up now, but hottest I've gotten it is 160. That's where it levels out. So, and I picked up a whole other tractor, 3813. I've got three of them now. But I picked this one up. It was sitting out in some guy's field. He sells tractors. Everything's here. I don't know how I keep getting lucky. But I pulled the PTO, believe it or not, PTU, whatever you'll call it, off the front of it, and believe it or not, it was actually good. Brake discs, friction discs, and everything was good. I was really surprised. So, needless to say, for $50, I got a whole other tractor, a new PTO. It's got the bagger attachment on the back. I think he had a bagger there. I'm going to go back and look, and if he does, I'm going to steal it off of him for money, obviously. But, yeah, the deck works and everything now. I got it backed up to the river. Yeah, I'm pretty happy now. I ain't got to spend the $170. I do need to get a new one just in case down the road, but. So, well, there it is. Let's see if I. kind of see it starting to move off of 130. I don't want to sit here and make this video 10 minutes long just so you can see it, but it's about at 140 now. So everything works, but like I said, that old pressure gauge, I don't know why it's sticking. I don't know, maybe if I got that plastic a little too tight or what. So, there you go.